Many people say, you know, in the 2019 elections, what choice do we have? If not Modi, who? My answer is, that's not the right question that you should be asking. The right question is Modi what? In the 2014 elections, every third Indian voter voted for Mr. Modi. But I was reassured, even then, that some of them voted because they hate India's minorities and they believe in a Hindu Rashtra. And in that sense, they are opposed to India's constitution. But I believe that a significant number of those 1 in 3 voters voted for him because they bought into this idea that he would create jobs, he would fight corruption, he had a magic wand which would solve the problem. But now, in 2019, all fig leaves have been dropped, all mirages have disappeared. No one can claim that we are voting for Modi because we hope he'll do great things with the economy, that he'll fight crony capitalism. None of that now carries any credibility with anybody. Today, if he is voted in, whoever votes for him is voting because they support his agenda of hate. And they are voting against the constitution of India. They're voting against the legacy of India's freedom struggle. They're voting against India's entire civilizational legacy of pluralism and respect for diversity. That is what they're doing. I'm recognizing more and more the problem is not there. It's not him, it's us. If he loses, we will have the space to begin a very long battle across at least 2 generations to reclaim an idea of India where we restore compassion, love, respect into our social relations.